Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.1 in the module Program Evaluation and Review Technique, popularly known as PET, and the Critical Path Method, which is known as CPM. The topic is PERT CPM. This is the first lecture on the PERT CPM. And the topic for the discussion is construction of the PERT network based on the precedence relationship and time estimates, calculation of time estimates and the variance. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to construct the PERT network for the given precedence relationship and calculate the variance of various activities. The Program Evaluation Review Technique, PET and CPM. The terminologies used in the PET and CPM. So the first terminology is activity. The activity is A. A is the activity in the diagram here. An activity is in the project is a job requiring time and resources for its completion. So in a huge net project, the project like ship building, construction of a huge apartment, construction of road, laying the road, construction of big shopping mall, it involves lakhs and lakhs of various activities, different activities. We prepare a chart to integrate all the activities and find out the time of completion of the entire project work. For any huge project work or a small project work, we have to prepare the network diagram connecting various activities using the precedence relationship and calculating various parameters so that we complete the project in time. And knowing the time, and we can pump the requirement, the various resources and the allotting the men and the calculating the time. So any project consumes the time, resources. Resources, it may be in terms of material, men or other resources. The activity is represented by an arrow. An arrow is commonly used to represent an activity with its head indicating the direction of the progress in the project. So this is the indication of an activity, and there are two events, I and J. I is known as tail event and J is known as head event, and this is the direction of progress of the particular activity or particular project. And so like it is a single activity, so this is the representative diagram. We have shown here a single activity, so like that hundreds of activities are connected to complete the entire project work, and that project work is represented by an arrow diagram. And the I and J, they are the event. And event represent the point in time that signifies the completion of certain activity and beginning of the new activity. So this is the completion of activity A. So this is the beginning of the activity A, and J is the point completion of activity A. Then the further the other activities will start from here, J, and proceed till the end of the project work. So these are all the terminology: activity, arrow, arrow diagram and event. Again, tail event, head event, these are all the various terminologies used in the PET and CPM network. And rules for constructing a network. So the length of the arrow have no relevance to the duration of activity. So length does not mean it consumes more time. So length has no connection with the duration of the activity. The events are numbered in such a way that the events of higher number can happen only after the events of the lower number has happened. So we number, so in the previous single diagram, single activity, we numbered the events as I and J. Now, we in a huge project work, there will be hundreds of events, and the events are numbered. There is a technique to number the event, and the higher number will be completed only after the completion of the lower number. The starting time of the first event is taken as 0. So starting time, the first event, the starting time equal to 0. each activity should be represented by one and only arrow in the network diagram. So, no multiple lines. So, one line for one activity. No two events can be indicated by the same head and the tail event. So, there is only for any single activity, there will be one tail event and one head event. Dummy activities may be introduced to keep the logic of sequence which represent the precedence relationship and does not consume time and resources. So, sometimes when the precedence relationships are not given, so we have to connect them by dummy activity which does not consume any resource or the time. The dummy activities are represented by the dotted line in the network diagram. Looping and dangling must be avoided in the network. Looping we know, the starting and the ending activities are connected by backward and forward arrow, that is not permitted. Dangling means hanging freely, activity or event should not hang freely in the network diagram. They should have some logical relationship between the previous activity and the future activity. All events except the first and the last must have at least one activity terminating into and one emerging from the activity. So, the initial event, there is no first event, there is no incoming arrow. Similarly, last event, there is no outgoing arrow. Otherwise, all the other activity will have minimum one incoming arrow and one outgoing arrow. The network must have one starting and one finishing point. There is no multiple starting and multiple finishing point. One starting point and one finishing point. And rules for numbering the events. So, there is certain set of rules too for numbering the event. It is given by D.R. Fulkerson. So, using this technique, identify the initial event of the network in which only arrows emerging out, not entering in. So, first event you have to identify. So, the first event is numbered as 1. And delete the arrow emerging from the event number 1. At least one event will become the initial event then at this stage. So, number the event as 2, 3, etc. Then delete the arrow emerging out of the numbered event and go to the step 3. So, once again you number the event and delete the arrow. So, like that we have to continue the process till the end event is arrived from which there is no outgoing arrow. A simple procedure is followed to number the event. So, we will take up some example so that you will understand the how to draw the network and how to number the event. The first example number 1. Draw the network diagram for the data given. So, there are activities A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S. There are activities A to S and the immediate predecessor. So, A, it is the first activity. So, B can start only completion of A, after completion of A. Similarly, C can emerge only after completion of A. D, after B and C. E, F, G after completion of D, H after completion of G, I after completion of H, J after completion of D, K after completion of J, L after completion of D, M after completion of L, N after completion of D, O after completion of N, P after completion of O, Q after completion of E, F, P, R after completion of Q, I, K and S after completion of M and R. So, these are all the precedence relationship. Now, we will construct the network. So, this is the data given in the problem. So, A is the first activity. So, this is the initial event. This is the second event. The events are connected by the activity A. Now, B and C will start only after completion of A. So, B starts from A after A and C is also starting after A. Then, D starts after B and C. So, B and C are completed. Then, the D starts. So, D starts here after completion of C, but B we have to connect. So, D will start only after the completion of B and C. So, now we have to connect these two events by a dummy activity. So, this dotted line is known as dummy activity. Then E will start after D. So, this is E and F will start after D. This is F. So, the E and F, they are connected by the dotted line. Again, dummy activity. And G will start after D. G will start after D. H will start after G. So, H activity, H is starting after D. I will start after H, then K will start after J. So, I will start after H and J will start after D. So here we have the activity D, then J will start after D, K will start after J. K will start after J, so K is also connected here to this event, and this L will start after D. So L is starting after D, this is the activity L. M will start after L, so M is the activity, so this is the event. So N will start after D, so N is starting from here and this is the activity. Then O will start after N, so this is the activity O, and this P will start after O, so P will start after O, and Q will start after EFP. So EFP, these activities are ending in this event, and now the Q starts. So Q starts and it is connected to this event, and the activity R starts after Q, I and K. So Q, I and K, now the R starts. So this R activity is connected here, and S activity, S will start after M and R. So M and R, this is the S. So this is the network for the precedence relationship given in the problem. So you understand the logic of, so normally use pencil to draw the circle and to draw the arrowhead. Then later on, once you confirm, normally you use the pencil. If it is any mistake, you can rub it off and you can correct it again. So this is the construction, way of constructing the PERT network for the given precedence relationship. So this is the dummy activity. As we said earlier, so the dotted dummy activity is represented by a dotted line which is not consuming any time or resources. We take another example to understand the methodology of constructing the network. So there are activity from A to N, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M and N, and there are precedence relationship, immediate predecessor. So A, B, C, D, after completion of these are all the independent activities starting initially. E is started after A, F is started after B, G is started after E, H is after F, I after C, D, G, H, J after I, K after I, L after J and K, M after J and K, and N after M. So we will take the diagram once again. So this is the initial event. And the four activities A, B, C, D, they are independently starting. So starting from the initial event, all these, there is no precedence activity for A, B, C, D. Now E after A, so E activity E after A, then F after B, so F after B, so this is the activity F after B, G after E, so this is activity G after the E, and it is connected to the C. Then H after F, so the H after F, this is also connected to this event, so after F. Then these two are connected by the dummy activity. Now this is the dummy activity. The next activity I after completion of C, D, G, H. C, D, G, H, all the activities are connected to this event. Now from here we start the activity I. So I is starting from starting after completion of C, D, H and G. So the D and this event, they are connected by the dummy activity, and here we have I, and J after I, so J after I, and K after I, so K is after I, so this is another activity. Now L after J and K. So J and K, we have to start L. So these two are connected by the dummy activity, and L starts after J and K. So there is no connection between these two events, so we connect by a dummy activity. Then L, M after JK. So M after, L is completed here, and M after JK. So JK is completed, M is started here, and N after M. So this is the final event and this is the initial event for the entire network. So these two examples will be make you familiar in constructing the network, and you have a book, if you have a book, you can take some example and you can try on your own so that you can construct the network effectively. And the next topic is PERT time estimate. So there are three different timings. So one is optimistic time estimate. It represented by TO. It defined the shortest time required for the completion of an activity. So minimum time required for completion of activity. Pessimistic time, it represents by TP. It is defined as the maximum possible time requiring for the completion of an activity. And the most likely time estimate, it represents by TM. The time required for completion of activity at normal working condition is known as most likely time. So these are all the times will be given. Optimistic time, which is very shortest time, minimum time required for completion of activity. Pessimistic time, the maximum time required for completion of activity. Most likely time, normal working environment or working condition, the time required is normal working time or the most likely time estimate. So from the three time values, we have to calculate expected time or the average time for completion of an activity. So this is very important. This calculation is important. So further, all our further calculation, future calculation will be based on the expected time or the average time. And we have a formula TE equal to TO plus 4TM plus TP divided by 6. So TO is the optimistic time or the minimum time. TM is the most likely time and TP is the pessimistic time or the maximum time divided by 6. So this is what we are going to calculate in future for all the activities. TE is the expected time or average time of an activity. And from the values given, we have to calculate the standard deviation sigma TP minus TO divided by 6. TP is the pessimistic time, which is maximum time. TO is the optimistic time, which is the minimum time divided by 6. And the variance is V equal to sigma square, which is TP minus TO by 6 whole square. Now, we take one example to understand the calculation of the various time estimate. A project consists of 8 activities with the time estimates are given below. Draw the network, number the event, determine the expected time and the variance. So there are activities A to H, 8 activities, and the precedence relationship also given. So A, B, C are the independent activities starting at the beginning, D after A, E after B, F after C, G after DE, and H after FG. And the timings are given, TO time, TO optimistic time, most likely time and the pessimistic time are given here, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 4, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5, 5, 6, 2, and pessimistic time, 7, 7, 8, 1, 14, 8, 13, 3. These are all the time estimates. We have to draw the network, number the event, and determine the expected time and the variance. First, let us draw the network. We draw the network starting from the initial event. There are three activities emerging, A, B, C, independently emerging. So these are all the three activities independently emerging from here. So your activity A, B, C, and the D, activity D after A. So this is D after A, and E after B. So E after B, F after C. So this is activity F, and G after DE. So after completion of DE, this is G, which is connected to this event, and H after FG. So this H activity after F and G, and this is the final event. So initial event, three activities are emerging from the initial event. There is activity D is after A, activity E after B, activity G after D and E, activity F after C, activity H after G and F. This is the network diagram for the given problem. Now we have to numbering the event of the network diagram. So these are all the activities from the previous diagram. So we have to start with 1. So the first event or the initial event is numbered as 1. So after numbering the event, we have to delete the arrow emerging from the event. So there are three activities, three arrows line emerging from here, you completely delete it. Now there are new initial events. So these are all the three initial events, number them as 2, 3, 4. So 2, 3, 4 the next numbering. And now from 2, you delete the activity D. So nothing is new, no new event, because here there is a completion, there is an incoming arrow. Now you delete E also, and this becomes the initial event. Now this becomes 5. Now delete the activity G. This activity is deleted. Now it is not emerging new event or the initial event. G also deleted. Now this becomes initial event and this is 6. And finally you drop the H and this is the final event. So the events are from 1 to 7 and activities are 1 to A to H. So these are all the this is the network diagram with numbering. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we calculate the timing. So this is the activity A to H, tail event 1, head event is 1, activity B, tail event is 1, head event is 3, activity C, tail event is 1, head event is 3, activity D, tail event is 2, head event is 5, activity E, 3, tail event is 3, head event is 5, activity F, 4 and 6, activity G, 5 and 6, activity H, 6 and 7. And these are all the time, TO, TM, TP, the time estimate, all the times are given in the problem. We calculate TE using this formula, TE equal to TO plus 4TM plus TP divided by 6. And the time estimates are 2, 4, 3, 1, 6, 5, 7, 2. Then we calculate the standard deviation using the formula sigma equal to TP minus TO divided by 6. For the first activity, 7 minus 1, 6 divided by 6 equal to 1. Again, second activity, 7 minus 1 divided by 6 equal to 1, 8 minus 2 divided by 6 equal to 1, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, 14 minus 2, 12 divided by 6 equal to 2, 8 minus 2, 6 divided by 6 equal to 1, 13 minus 3, 10 divided by 6 equal to 1.67, 3 minus 1, 2 divided by 6 equal to 0.33. And the variance equal to sigma square, TP minus TO divided by 6 whole square. So 1 square is 1, so here 1, third row 1, 0, 2 square 4, 1 square 1, 1.67 square equal to 2.79, 0.33 square equal to 0.11. So these are all the variance of various activities, and the variance will be useful for calculating the probability of completing the entire project work. So later on we will be using a problem to calculate the probability of completing the project work within the given time. For that the variance is very important. So we stop here. These are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can find the operation research book, refer to it for additional information on the pertinent CPM. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. Subscribe the YouTube channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject pertinent CPM. Until then, bye-bye.